Bonnie Laufer joins us via Skype after speaking with the stars of some great movies to stream. Hi, Bonnie. I got a crazy inbox. I just saw Good morning. I just saw this email from you. Hey, Bob, can you confirm? Are we on at 8:20? Yeah, we're on at 8:20, Bonnie.
Hey, Bob, I've been sitting here since 5 in the morning just in case. I'm all ready for you.
Well, we're glad we got you here. It's amazing, of course, in this pandemic. I mean, all the movies that have headed to streaming.
It just
theaters not being
stop.
Available to us. It doesn't, which is good because we need the entertainment.
Exactly. Yeah. Well, let's start off with our good friend Viggo Mortensen.
Yes.
He's always been so good to Canada. His new film, Falling, which starts streaming on Friday, is absolutely wonderful. I saw this back at the Toronto Film Festival. This film was entirely shot in Ontario, so of course he's devoted to us as always. But it's really wonderful. It's his directorial debut. He stars in it. He wrote it. He wrote the music for it. He probably did craft service and poured coffee for everybody. There's nothing that this man cannot do. And it's a very touching story. He plays John, a gay man, who is dealing with his father's Alzheimer's. His father is played by Lance Henriksen. And sometimes, you know what, Bob, it's so hard to watch because his father, as he's going deeper and deeper into the dementia, his language, what he says to him, it's so hurtful. But it's just so real, and it's based on a little bit of Viggo's life growing up with his parents, but not exactly, but very little. So when Viggo and I spoke, he's now spending his pandemic in Spain. How good is that? We talked from his home in Spain. And I asked him about his collaboration with actor Lance Henriksen.
I think I was helpful to him because I wasn't just a director standing outside trying to help him do his best job possible with the character. I was in there with him on an equal footing, you know, as two actors trying to figure out some very difficult emotional scenes. Mm-hmm. And I think we made a good team. It was a great experience. I really enjoyed watching him build that character from the start.
You know where the door is, my friend. Really, really interesting film. And, you know, I asked Viggo also if he had taken anything from any directors that he's worked with. And, of course, he's worked with David Cronenberg for so many movies. And he gives Cronenberg a great cameo in this film. He plays a proctologist. So, pretty funny. Huh?
You know, I would just turn around in that waiting room if I...
I just honestly, can you imagine if Jeff Goldblum walked into the room? Forget it. Anyway. Yeah.
That would just go horribly wrong medically.
Fly.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. We digress.
Anyway,
Firefly Lane.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Firefly Lane is a new series that starts streaming on Netflix tomorrow, actually, and it's based on Kristen Hannah's best-selling book. It's about two women. They meet as young girls, and it shows the spread of their friendship over 30 years. It stars Canadian Sarah and Michael as two girls as they grow up, and we see them obviously in the older years. But the younger years are played by two wonderful Canadian actresses, Roan Curtis and Ali Scopey. And I spoke to these two girls and I asked them, you know, how much, if they had read the book, if they knew anything about it. So let's have a listen to my interview with those two ladies.
I fell in love with it instantly. She's, you know, an incredible author, and the story is so authentic and very real. And I loved it from like the first three pages I was already in love. So.
Yeah. And Roan, how about you?
Yeah, I hadn't read the book beforehand, but I also just read it and was totally in love. I don't think I've ever cried so hard reading a book before. And at multiple points too, like it had me like laughing and then crying. My boyfriend was like, "Are you okay?" And I was like, "No, I'm feeling a lot of things right now."
I'm gonna be there for you.
Yeah, it's just a lovely little series. It's fun to watch their relationship. Katherine Heigl actually pretty shines in this series. I kind of liked her performance in this, and the young girls are so great. And anyways, it's a girls thing. Watch at home. You know, I don't know how much the husbands will want to watch this, but the women absolutely will love this series. So lots of fun with Firefly Lane, Netflix.
Yeah. There's a guy Canadian in that one too, Brandon J. McLaren. And nice to see in these two shows or movies, the Canadian cast members, Canadian content.
Well, this one was actually all shot in Burnaby, like in BC, and it's got a huge crew that's Canadian. A lot of actors that are in it are Canadian. So it's got a very heavy Canadian contingency. So just for that, Watch it, everybody.
Yeah.
Yeah, keep us working here.
Now, the next one takes us to Hawaii.
Yeah. I'm traveling because, boy, on a plane for this one. But you know what? You get to see all of Hawaii. This is a fun family film. Really, really a lot of fun. It's called Finding Ohana. It's a summer. It takes place in the summer in Oahu. And these two Brooklyn-raised siblings find a journal, and they set out to find some treasure. She meets a friend there. So this is starring Kia Pehu and Owen Vaccaro, the two kids who star in it. They're lovely. Owen, we've seen in a lot of things, you know, lots of movies. But Kia, this is her very, very first role. So I asked her, you know, I asked them both about, you know, tough life, kids. You get to shoot this whole movie in Hawaii. So we talked about that and how Kia kind of related to her character.
I think we filmed in the southern part of Oahu and the northern part of Oahu, yeah. And like all of these different places in Thailand, from like Krabi to Phuket to Bangkok. And it was just like, these are the places that I feel like I've always dreamed of going. And I'm just so happy that I was able to like be able to. And it was such a crazy experience. I also didn't know like a thing about the Hawaiian culture. And so being on this,
yes,
you can see my dog, being on the set, I was able to learn so much because a lot of the cast and crew was from Hawaii. And so I'm really happy that I was able to learn a lot about, you know, the culture.
Oh yeah, I learned a lot watching this film too. I you know, it's fantastic. Now, Kay, I want to ask you, because Pili, she's very adventurous. She's courageous. She really, you know, she'll try almost anything. How much did you relate to her?
So Pili and I actually have kind of similar backgrounds. She's from Oahu and then she moved to Brooklyn, New York, and, you know, she has a life there. And I'm from Oahu and I moved to LA to pursue my dreams of acting and dancing. And I feel like we're both also active. She's active on the more adventurous side. You know, she's a geocacher and she likes brave, and I'm a dancer. So, you know, I like to compete and perform in my crew, The Lab. And the difference between us is that I've actually never geocached in my life before.
Yeah, it's just a lot of fun for the family. You can sit there and watch it. Nothing offensive, and a great little adventure that you can all take together and travel to Hawaii together as a family.
Great.
From your couch.
Yeah. Great pandemic picks. And we'll link up your socials for more ideas. Bonnie Laufer, good to see you. See you again.
Nice to see you. See you again soon. Take care, guys.